aging, longevity, lifespan. These are buzzwords which are exciting investors and scientists. Countries like Saudi Arabia have invested $1 billion every year to reverse aging like if it was a disease. But in this video, I will explain you that it's not necessarily needed because the solution is already in our body. Humans have been dreaming for a long time about immortality. And nowadays, you have all these pills, supplements, which are promising you to live a long life and extend your life. I am Robin Mesnage, and part of the Buchinger Wilhelmi clinics. I'm also a scientist at King's College London. And today I will explain you everything about this field of longevity. And I will explain you in particular why fasting is the most powerful approach to live a healthy lifespan and maybe even extend lifespan. I make a difference between lifespan and healthy lifespan. This is very important because humans have never been living that long. That is true. And you have more and more people living 70, 80 years or more. But at the same time, we have more and more disease. So lifespan, the number of years you will live in your life, this is increasing. Healthy lifespan, your number of years in good health, this is decreasing. And nowadays, one in two people will develop a cancer in their lifetime. One in three people will develop neurobehavioral disease, neurodegenerative disease, or psychiatric disorders. You have one in three Americans who have prediabetes. One in four have fatty liver disease. Because we are more and more developing some disease, mostly because of our unhealthy lifestyle, poor diet, inactivity, and exposure to many toxic chemicals. There's many companies trying to sell you pills or drugs for dealing with that. And I can explain you why drugs, because this is the main model in our society. Drugs are very profitable for companies because they can patent them, they can be considered as new invention, and they can make a lot of profit out of that. Drugs are a good business for companies, but they may not be so good always for you as a consumer. They can be expensive for national healthcare systems and for you. They can also have many side effects. Some are mild, like chronic fatigue or dizziness. But sometimes some drugs can lead to more serious effects and lead to an escalation towards another chronic disease. They can become unavailable also because of political reason or socio-economic reason. And let's face it, our world is not at a stable time, and it's probably not a good time to rely on a drug to live a normal lifestyle. Drugs, they can also have many effects on the ecosystem because their residues end up in rivers near big cities, and this is affecting the population of wild animals. Fish in these rivers, they mostly become infertile, they have difficulties to feed, and so this is a big problem. By contrast, we can leverage the self-healing abilities of our body. There are other new technologies which are developed to reverse aging like if it was a disease. Some are called cellular reprogramming. I can briefly explain you what it is. Cellular reprogramming, this is a technique which is based on genetic modification. And basically, you try to hijack the factors which are responsible for human developments so that a cell can reverse its development, and then you rejuvenate the body. These are very beautiful demonstrations, very elegant scientific papers, but I doubt that it will be working in our society. Because these genetic modifications, this is like gene therapy. It costs millions for one intervention. And gene therapy, this has been working for decades, but this is only available for rich people. And there is really a big problem in developing some technologies which are only accessible for a few individuals. By contrast, some interventions can be free and you can rely on the self-healing abilities of your body. Because Our cells have evolved for millions of years and are now equipped to deal with aggressions. They can detect and repair damage. Dysfunctional cells can be eliminated. We can detoxify toxic chemicals in our body. And our body is constantly renewing. Take the skin, for instance. If you cut yourself, the skin will heal in a couple of days. Our intestine, it has a big turnover. The surface of our intestine is replaced every couple of days. And there are techniques that you can use to leverage these self-healing abilities. And one of the most efficient, this is fasting. Fasting is very good for that because we have evolved in our long evolution to tolerate and deal with these periods when food was not available by rejuvenating our body and regenerating our body in these times. This is what happens when you fast. You trigger the activation of some mechanisms like autophagy. This is a process which is like circular economy for your body. You recycle the damaged component to make new cells. You have also an activation of stem cell division, so your body is renewed with more and younger cells. And I can also explain you why actually fasting is one of the best strategies for dealing with healthy longevity. When you look at catalogs for lifestyle intervention, some are available on governmental websites, like on the NIH website for the US, you can see that caloric restriction and fasting, these are the most powerful approach to extend healthy lifespan. And when you look at other drugs or supplements which are sold for the same purpose, they are mostly imitating the effect of fasting. Take rapamycin, for instance. Rapamycin, this is very efficient, but it's just imitating the effect of fasting by inactivating a molecular system called mTOR. This is responsible for the metabolic switch during fasting. When you start burning your fat and your regenerative mechanisms are activated in the body. Take spermidine, for instance. Spermidine, this is activating autophagy, and autophagy is also one of the hallmarks of fasting. So why not do the real thing instead of relying on these supplements or drugs? And fasting has very good effects for longevity. This can be explained by our evolution. In the wild, there is an advantage to extend lifespan and even regenerate the body when food is missing. Because in wild animals, what they strive for is reproduce. And when food is not available, reproducing and having an offspring is maybe not a good idea because they will not survive. So animals are generally reproducing in spring when food is available. And when the food is not available in their body, there is mechanisms which are regenerating the cells. The body is switching into a sort of eco mode. This is the fasting metabolism. And in this case, the animal can wait for a better period so he can have an offspring. This can be a bit abstract for our human lives because we are completely disconnected from these wildlife considerations, but this can allow you to understand why fasting is probably the best way to extend healthy longevity, because this is leveraging these self-healing abilities of your body. So to conclude, I really hope that we will embrace the self-healing abilities of our bodies by integrating fasting into the medical practice and also doing more research on it, because this is not a magic bullet, but probably one of the most efficient tools in our toolbox. Thank you for watching this video. And if you want to know more about fasting or our research, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel and watch other videos.